seen this yet, Ralph?
Yeah.
What'd you think of this?
I honestly, I've had a lot of input into it. I haven't seen it to, I mean, I was sent to me for a couple days ago. I haven't had an opportunity to really sit down with Darcy and I talked to her today. And we want to get together with our athletic directors and make an appointment. And I mean, we still want to kick at it and look at it, but yeah, generally speaking, we're very pleased because we think this will meet some of the needs we have. And I think it's being really cost conscious, you know, to the taxpayer, really. We're trying our best to do that because we, you know, we recognize that's very important. But we also have needs. We're educating kids in 2018 in a building that, you know, was first built in 1970. And there's some, the science areas need work. There's other places that need work. And that's sometimes a tough pill to swallow for some people, but it needs to get done. And these guys have been very responsive. And we've had some really good input from our science teachers, from counseling, everybody else. And we think this would help us, you know, achieve our vision and our goals to better educate the students here.
So then if we step upstairs to the second floor.
Thank you.
Second floor is, again, organization that looks very similar to what we reviewed in our last meeting. You remember in our last conversation, we talked a fair amount about our two library spaces and kind of figuring out how much of that we need. How much space do we need to offset some of the loss in classrooms on the first floor? So what you're seeing proposed on your plan is a dedicated library labeled LMC. Okay. This basically takes the library footprint and pulls it to the south. Okay. Our goal is to get access to that off of the main corridor. Okay. Right now it feels a little counterintuitive to have to go down those small corridors to access that library. It seems like having a main entry, if you will, right off this corridor makes a lot of sense. So our thought is pull this down, which allows us to back here basically all of the library support, the office space for librarians, the archive space, any of the storage starts to tuck in, and then we start stacking classrooms along that corridor, right? So we can feed those off of this corridor. Then we flip to the other side, we do the same thing with the classrooms along the corridor. Again, pulling down off of our main east-west trunk corridor would be a student support commons. It's a label that I think really starts to kind of be broad enough that it starts to include a lot of things we've talked about as a group, as maybe there's some benefits to having a kind of student success center portion of the building. Okay, and so what we're starting to do is have some dialogues and create some space around what might go into supporting those students. So again, it's going to be career and college kind of support. It may be some tutoring centers, some writing centers, writing labs. We're also showing a testing center as part of this, so there may be a dedicated spot for testing support. We're also showing two LGI presentations. LGI is large group instruction. Okay, so again, that's where we bring together large quantities of students for a direct lecture or a keynote. They're next to each other for a reason, so that we can consider having the ability to open this wall up and have some flexibility to do even larger groups. Is that tiered or not, and fixed seating or not? We're not sure, right? So we'll kind of determine that as we go forward. But we think having that directly off of the commons, so as commons, you can imagine coming down this corridor, basically being able to spill in and out of this area. Okay, soft seating, tables, chairs, the ability to access each of these rooms off of potentially that center. I think has a lot of kind of exciting merit to what that could add to the school.
Yeah, I think this captures a lot of efficiencies too. I mean, because some of that footage is, like I said, space that was designed a long time ago. We're trying to, you know, fit people in places where maybe it doesn't work really well, but it's the best we can do right now. But if we can get everybody in one area, a support service area, then we've got a lot of collaboration. We've got people who don't have to walk to another side of the building, downstairs, upstairs. Now, that may not seem like a big deal to some people, but that, you know, it's nicer to be, this is a very college-like model right here. And we wanted to do something like that. And the space then we're gonna capture by moving those classrooms there We can move all of our English teachers then together, so they're not on the first floor, second floor, east. We've got a plan so those people all, you know, are in the same area teaching together. And, you know, the library spaces, frankly, great at one time, but somebody, you know, at one time, you know, we needed libraries like that. We don't anymore. So I think this is very kind of smart.
Have you compared the number of classrooms in this new design?
That's what I need to do.
Oh, okay.
That's what I was trying to. I haven't dug deep enough yet, and I want to count how many classrooms are used each period of the day and in which area, English, math, science, you name it.
Yeah.
And I want to break it down like that. And I just haven't had time, and that's what we're going to do next.
It
so,
just looks like more. So
yeah, we don't want to go, and that's what, you know, we don't want to all of a sudden waste things, or maybe we can do something different, you know, maybe we, you know.
Keep in mind the first floor, yeah, where we moved the admin offices, as well as what's across, all those are all classrooms today. So really, in a way, losing a lot of those education spaces too. So we believe we're close, but we'll work.
We're probably close, but that's exactly what I need to do.
So if we go down to one library, how much square feet are we gaining that we could potentially use to drop back some of that 18,500 addition?
Again, I don't know that we recommend you put locker rooms up there.
Well, I'm not saying.
So I'm not sure, then you can't compare those. If we're solving in the new construction for locker rooms, we can't suggest that saving renovation square footage upstairs could cut down on locker room space.
Well, you'd have to reconfigure more than just that. I'm just wondering, what is that square foot?
What is the library square foot additional? I don't know, maybe Craig.
It's 28,000.
That's about me, okay.
But I think, Mary, you just kind of illustrated a good point, and that's the efficiencies that you lose with renovation. In terms of layout, you know, you're absolutely right that the square footage is there, but it's not in the right spot. And those are the efficiencies that you do lose with it from a remodel project versus the.
But the locker room is currently somewhere else now, and you're putting classrooms there. I'm just saying it's a possibility.
No, I understand what you're saying.
Yeah, I know what you're saying too, Mary, and that's why I want to sit down and I want to make sure we're not all of a sudden getting 15 new classrooms, and we don't need 15 new classrooms. Mm-hmm. Maybe we could just keep the locker rooms as is and just remodel on that thing. So yeah, we've got to go through that.
Okay. But I think they're not suggesting putting a student support commons just because of their space too. That, you know, that's something that we have discussed, though, that would be a very nice addition to the high school, like Ralph said, at the college atmosphere. So it's not just saying, well, we don't need two libraries, you know, it's saying this would be a really good, timely, you know, change,
yeah,
to make with the space we have.
Mm-hmm. You know, I think a lot of things that surround that space we're doing today. Right, we're providing that service, but we're providing it in duplicative space or spread out disjointly throughout the building, so that this would be an opportunity to collect all that in one area, if you will, and try to kind of maximize that.
I was very much opposed to doing anything to the library. I thought having two libraries was the way to go, but Barb Dieters, whose library knowledge far surpasses mine, when she thought that this was a good idea, I thought, well, if the experts think that that's the way to go, I'm with it. And what you've come up with today, I think you've done a good job.
Great.
Even the local West Bend Library is looking at combining statewide resources, actually.
But that's
electronic resources.
That's resources, that's not space.
Yeah, but I think a lot of them have been, at Rain Park, we've been pulling down our library spaces, remodeling,
sure,
because everything's been moving more towards electronic resources.
Yeah.
I just had a quick question. The classrooms on the second story look like they're good sized classrooms. I'm just curious if you had a rough estimate on what the dimensions of those classrooms, as well as like the first floor math classrooms, are a little bit smaller.
Let's just say standard like this guy here, Craig. So what you're seeing in this is,
right,
900 square feet. So you can see your existing.
They're probably looking like a 20 by 40 type square there.
30 by 30 would be 90.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's appropriate for having student populations,
yeah,
of like 30.
We our class sizes run, you gotta remember, when that building was built,
just
a
little more rectangular than square.
A lot of us who went to school here never sat, well, maybe I shouldn't say never. I didn't sit in classrooms where there were 32 other students, unless it was study hall,
yeah,
or something, a big group lecture. My class sizes back then, they were capping them at 22,
yeah,
23. we're now at 30, 31, 32 students, so getting a little larger size classroom and kids are.
At Brain Park, the problem we'll have is they'll renovate an area and they'll give us a long, narrow classroom, and it just doesn't work, because to maintain the ADA compliance, you can't lay out the room, because you're constantly wishing, gosh, I wish I had another 6 feet in this room.
And one of the things.